Ananta samsara samudra tara naukayita abhyam guru bhakti dhabhyam vairagya samrajya dapujana abhyam namo namashri guru paduka abhyam Shri Guru Bhyo Namaha. Happiness is the cry of mankind. Everyone is seeking after happiness directly or indirectly, knowingly or unknowingly. So, we can categorically say that our life is a great struggle for happiness. What kind of happiness we want? We want everlasting happiness. We want pure happiness. We want unalloyed happiness. Now the question is, why we are all searching for this kind of happiness? The Upanishad, the most ancient scripture of this world, says we are all searching for this kind of happiness because happiness is our own true nature. Anando brahmeti vyajanat. Happiness is our own true nature. So Upanishad says the eagerness of one's own desire to become perfectly happy is clue to the fact that pleasure is one's nature. We are all searching for this kind of happiness because the true nature is happiness. Happiness is our own true nature. So Upanishad says, we are not this gross body, sense organs, mind and intellect. We are all identifying ourselves, this gross body, mind and intellect. But Upanishad says, this wrong identification is root cause for all our miseries. According to Upanishad, as long as we are identifying ourselves with this perishing objects like body, sense organ, mind and intellect, we cannot come out from the miseries of this world. So Upanishad says, we are not this gross body, we are not this sense organs, we are not this mind, we are not this intellect, we are the power behind this body, sense organs, mind and intellect. We are the everlasting bliss. We are the self. This supreme knowledge is called self-knowledge. So according to Upanishads, only this supreme self-knowledge brings ultimate liberation, that is moksha. According to Upanishads, only this supreme knowledge liberates us from the clutches of birth and rebirth. So, now let us see what is this self-knowledge. According to Adi Shankara, the greatest philosopher of this world, the founder of Advaita philosophy, the establisher of our Hariharapuram Dharma Peetam, self-knowledge or Atmajnana is to discover one's own true nature, which is divinity itself. Adi Shankara says, Jnana is to discover one's own true nature, which is divinity itself. So, according to Adi Shankara, our true nature is pure happiness. The uniqueness and greatness of Adi Shankara is, he is the only one philosopher in this world who has given divinity to each and every human being. According to Adi Shankara, the founder of Advaita philosophy, monism, the final and absolute truth of Advaita philosophy is, all are divine, all are same, and all are one. Adi Shankara says, irrespective of your religion, irrespective of your caste and creed, irrespective of your worshipping God, irrespective of your gender, each and every human being has equal right and opportunity to realize this supreme self-knowledge, to realize this Atma-jnana. Now the question is, how to realize this Atma-jnana? Again, Shankara says, Mantra Dhyana is the most powerful, simple and effective method to experience this self-knowledge. Now let us see, what is this Mantra Dhyana? According to our Shastra, Mantra means Mananat Trayate Iti Mantraha. One who repeat this is protecting from all sorts of troubles and get both worldly and spiritual benefit, both worldly and spiritual happiness is mantra. One who repeat this is protecting from all sorts of troubles and get both worldly and spiritual happiness is mantra. Each mantra contains several bijaksharas, many seed letters. Each seed letters contains infinite divine energy in subtle form. For example, the seed letter Ayin. This is the bijakshara of knowledge. If you repeat this bijakshara, that is seed letter, with firm faith, it improves our memory power, grasping power and retaining power, and it also helps to get supreme self-knowledge. Similarly, the letter Shreem, it's the bijakshara of prosperity, wealth. So, if you do this Mantra Dhyana with firm faith, unshaking trust and pure devotion, definitely we can get both worldly and spiritual happiness in our life. But there is no shortcut in spiritual path. Only sincere practice makes you perfect. So, you have to do this Mantra Dhyana regularly, at least 4 hours at your home. That is daily 2 hours during morning and 2 hours during evening. And you have to do group meditation at least once in a week to get maximum benefit from this Mantra Dhyanam. So once again we say, there is no shortcut in spiritual path. Sincere practice makes you perfect. So sincere and regular practice is must. We pray the Supreme Lord for bestowing all welfare, well-being and prosperity to all of you in all your endeavors. Once again, we praise Supreme Lord sincerely for bestowing the supreme self-knowledge to all the members of this Shankara Mantra Dhyana group. Sarve janaha sukhino bhavanto. Narayana, Narayana, Narayana.